Hello, this is Yang Kun from Shanghai Jiao Tong University. This is joint work with Amazon Shanghai AI Lab. So our work focuses on the fundamental problem of graph neural networks, that is, how to improve the model accuracy of node classification. We propose several practical techniques which require minor changes in the implementation but can bring about a significant boost in performance. So first, ordinary classification tasks with no graphs take each sample independently. However, we observe that in graph data, node features are usually too weak where graph information is essential for classification. As a result, graph neural networks often suffer from low training accuracy. The traditional way is to train the model and take labels and the supervised signals for training. The problem is when some nodes are misclassified by the model, the ground truth label information is not contained in the model, although they can be used for inference. To illustrate this point, let me give an example. So let's suppose one of the two blue nodes has a weak node feature and is misclassified by the model to an orange class. Then the model will propagate its feature, potentially pollutes its neighbors. And in the worst case, the node features are so weak that they all have the same features. Then the graph neural networks can only guess the labels. However, actually, we have access to all the ground truth labels in the training set, which could provide additional information to the model. Since the model does not contain all the information of labels, we consider using labels as models, which allows GNNs to propagate ground truth labels to their neighbors. And one naive approach is to take labels as input directly, but then the model will learn some trivial degenerate solutions, for example, an identity mapping that ground truth labels merely pass directly from input to output, reaching zero training loss immediately. So to address the problem, we give an algorithm to utilize additional information from ground truth labels explicitly as model's input while overcoming the label leakage issue. Here's how the algorithm works. We first randomly split the training set into two subsets. After that, we take one subset of training node labels as model's input and predict the remaining one. In this way, we can prevent the label from learning identity mappings. And during the final inference process, all labels in the training set are used as inputs to the model. Based on this, we further propose label reuse, which predicts labels for multiple times. And in the first iteration, we split the training set as before, and then we recycle the predicted sub-labels of the previous iteration and use these sub-labels as input and do this for multiple times. Here's the pseudo code of our algorithm. In fact, there are approaches that combine GNN and label propagation that can solve the problem we just mentioned. But our motivation is different from theirs, and we have some advantages over existing approaches. First, our approach is capable of propagating features and labels during both training and inference stages. Second, our approach doesn't explicitly rely on the smoothness assumption of the label propagation algorithm. and can be conveniently adapted to various GNN architectures capable of handling heterogeneous and heterophilic graphs where this assumption may break down. And third, our approach can be trained end-to-end while avoiding the model learning trivial degenerate solutions. That is identity mapping whereby the ground truth labels merely pass directly from input to output training nodes. In addition, loss function is crucial for classification tasks. So next, we design a robust loss function that can prevent the misclassified nodes from dominating the training loss. As you know, the logistic loss, or called cross entropy loss, is one of the most commonly used loss functions, which is convex. However, as pointed out by some literature, this loss function is sensitive to outliers, whereas non-convex losses are more robust. So we consider using quasi-convex loss for robustness, just as the rho here, which is a non-decreasing function. This table illustrates some loss functions, including the robust Savage loss and the LQ loss. And we propose the Loge loss is the antibottom. This figure plots these loss functions and their derivatives. And ours is the dashed line here. As you can see, our Loge loss meets these criteria. First, while it helps to prevent outliers from dominating the training loss, it is unbounded compared to Savage and LQ loss. And the derivative converges slowly to zero as V decreases, meaning that it still provides non-negligible gradient signals for the misclassified samples as desired. Second, the maximum gradient magnitude occurs at V equals to zero, which enhances the gradient signal near the decision boundary, which is important for classification. The only other loss function with a maximum gradient at zero is the sigmoid loss. However, its tails converge to zero very fast, which can lead to a vanished gradient problem. Third, for correctly classified samples, that is the positive side, the derivative converges to zero relatively quickly as with other loss functions. However, in this regime, the gradient signal is less critical. Finally, we propose several variants of graph attention networks. First, we observe that the symmetric normalized adjacency used by GCN is crucial sometimes. So we propose the GAT with symmetric normalized adjacency as here. In this way, we make GCN a special case of GAT when the attention values are equal for all neighbors. And we then propose non-interactive attention mechanisms and the attention involving edge features. Each of these variants have a practical use in different scenarios. And here's our experiment result of label usage. And we can see our algorithm improves different models significantly and consistently. Here, the table above shows the results for different loss functions, where each label is trained with the same hyperparameters, varying only the loss functions. And our proposed loss outperforms other losses on most datasets and models. And in the table below, we see that GAT with a normalized adjacency matrix achieve higher performance on all datasets. That being said, we recommend choosing the appropriate adjacency matrix for different data sets. And this is the recent leaderboard of the most attempted node classification dataset on the Open Graph benchmark. And as you can see, then all of the 10 top ranked entries have benefited from our techniques. If you are interested in our work, please refer to our paper to learn more details, or ask me if you have any questions, and I'd be happy to answer. Thank you very much.